Man, what is going on, everybody? 392 Reviews here, man. Welcome back. I know it's been a long time, but welcome back to another. I would say beautiful day, but it, you know, it's hot as hot as Satan's toenail out here, man. This is definitely where the devil takes vacation, man. I don't know what the hell is going on with this humidity and this temperature in PA, but man, this gotta go. But y'all already know what it is, man. We doing another, you know, Mopar related video. You know, got the Daytona out. Not probably gonna be doing anything too crazy. I hate running the car when it's really hot out like that, but you know, probably just gonna go grab some food, post up somewhere, do a little topic. I'm not exactly sure what we're gonna be talking about today, but if you read the description up or down, who knows even where it is at this point, update after update, you're gonna get an idea of what we're gonna be talking about. I think we're gonna be talking about, you know, the Hemi and how it's not really going away. But at the end of the day, man, appreciate y'all watching. Throw a like, smash the like button, throw a comment, subscribe if you have not already, and without further ado, man, let's hop into the video. So of course, man, if y'all been watching, you know, if y'all watching this video, you're probably, you know, some sort of fan of Mopar, Dodge, you know, one sort or the other, you know, of one sort or the other, SRT, you know, definitely a fan of American Muscle and everything like that. So, you know, y'all know what's on the horizon, man. The last call Hemi's already went out for 2023 for the Charger Challenger, but now they just dropped a sneak peek saying that the 392 is gonna be back, but of course in the vehicle we don't want it back in, and that's the Jeep Wrangler. I don't know what it is about the Jeep Wrangler, man. I think those vehicles sell all day, every day without having the Hemi in it, the 392. Why not mess with putting a 5.7 in there, maybe not having the $90,000 price tag. Let's just go ahead, you know, make this little right turn. We're gonna let this guy come over. Yeah, come on, man. Hey, man, share the road if you can. Oh, shout out to all my low cars out there, man. Parking lots be crazy sometimes. But yeah, why they want to bring this $90,000-$95,000 Jeep Wrangler back on the lots? They're already sitting. We have one at my dealership. It's been sitting. It is an AEV, American Expedition Vehicle Outfit, but that joint been sitting for a long time, man. They had it at like 120. Now I think we're at 105. So wait any longer, man. They may chop another 15K off. Who knows? But I just gotta sit back and ask myself. Dodge, honestly, they're trying to get in line. You know, they're trying to get their ducks in order, however you want to call it, and you know, and sort of get with the feds with this whole, you know, environmentally friendly sustainability. You know, let's go EV. They're trying to follow the leader, and they're trying to get in line. It's biting them. The 4xEs are not really doing good. Jeep has their fair share of issues as it is with that vehicle already. But they're talking about bringing the 392 Hemi back. Listen, man, y'all tell me, y'all try to correct me if I'm wrong, man. Y'all tell me your opinions on it. Is that a good thing for Dodge? I mean, why would they give us the Wrangler? People want the Charger, the Challenger, maybe even the Durango before they want the Wrangler. Do y'all think that's a true statement? Do y'all think that's, you know, am I just talking out of my ass because I'm not a Wrangler fan? I've never been a Jeep fan, never will be a Jeep fan. If someone wanted to throw me the keys to a 392, I'd probably sell it and grab a regular Hellcat or something like that. Because you have this Jeep that is insanely overpriced, in my honest opinion. It's an amazing machine. 0 to 60 in like 4.4. Of course, the 392 is a Rubicon. Rubicon's already $70,000, already expensive as it is, so it's going to be, I think, even more, you know, even more challenging to get the right customer on that vehicle, because I think the Jeeps, you know, the people who love Jeeps, they don't love it for the motor. They love it for, you know, the off-road, taking the doors off, taking the top off, after the top off, you know, something like that. You know, shout out to Gunna if you know. They're not really sitting here saying, Dodge, give us the 392. I think they had leftover motors or supply chain for that vehicle, which is why they're doing, you know, what they're doing right now in regards to bringing that back. But I just have to sit back and ask why, man, and ask, you know, my subscribers, like, why? Maybe somebody can help me understand. I don't know why they would take that vehicle and bring it back. I know I'm kind of repeating myself, but I was kind of just dumbfounded on that aspect. You know, I saw, I think maybe even like Knockout 360 maybe made a video of it, but I'm just like thinking of all vehicles, Charger, Challenger, Durango, shit, man, even like the 2500s, even the, I mean the 1500s, they have the 5.7, but the 2500s, they still use the 6.4. Why are they choosing to bring it back with the Wrangler? It's already an issue getting this vehicle off the lot as it is. So, you know, Lord have mercy, you know, Lord help them. I don't know what they're gonna be doing, you know, with the vehicle sitting on lots anymore. But my guess is, my assumption is they had leftover either allocations or they had leftover raw materials for these vehicles. Maybe depending on what plant they had, you know, so on and so forth. Shout out to that homie in that WRX. Cruised with him up to Steel Stacks one time. Always around the area, good person. Definitely cool for sure. And if they're gonna hint at bringing the Wrangler back, what else do they have, you know, tucked up their sleeves? Are they going to do a very, very limited production of the new Charger with the Hemi? Are they just keeping that under wraps? Man, y'all let me know. Not exactly sure where I wanna get food, man. It's not really that bad of a day. It's kind of a nice day out, but there is a lot of traffic out here. So we just gonna kind of do what we do best and, you know, kind of mumble on about, man. Kind of go make a video and, again, just try to get back into it. I'm gonna try to start dropping videos twice a week. Shout out to the homie Chris, man, trying to get me back doing that. Maybe try to do Monday or Friday or something like that, you know. Who knows, man? At the end of the day, man, I just gotta get back to posting videos, and I know y'all like seeing the Charger and everything like that. Not sure if there's anything coming with the Charger in regards to modifications and everything like that. I know I hinted at my previous video about doing a new wrap, but I love this smoke show, man. I actually pulled the mirror caps off on the side, the carbon fiber. I just wanted to go back to seeing paint, man. Don't blame the kid, man. Don't blame the boy for it. You know, got a nice little Camaro out there, a nice little the G70? Yeah, real nice G70. Looks like it got some aftermarket wheels and tires. Shout out to that Camaro up there. Older body style. I forget what they call them, the long nose ones. I would say maybe that the early 2000s, I think that is. Maybe like 2003, 2004. I'm not a bow tie kid, man. I'm a Mopar fan for sure. Mopar and Mustang, even though I never really owned a Mustang, but that Mach 1, that GT350, let me tell you, man, even the GT500, man, golly, man, every time I hear one of them pups, man, it's fantastic. And of course, you can't go wrong with that 6-speed Tremec, however you want to call it. It's a fantastic, fantastic transmission. I've had the pleasure of driving a few Mach 1s that had it. Even the 10-speed's great, but putting around town kind of seems a little bit clunky. What do we think, y'all? Is Dodge going to keep playing these games of teasing the Hemi in these vehicles that people don't want? Let me know. Not gonna make a long video, man. I might try to do two videos today if possible. I see bitch staring crazy, man. I see you though. And if you're watching, sorry. At the end of the day, it's like give the people what they want. Absolutely give the people what they want. We don't want the Wrangler. Maybe I shouldn't speak for the mass. I'm speaking for most of the people I come in contact with who are Mopar fans. We don't want the Wrangler. They can have it. The Wrangler does just fine with the V6 at the price point it's at. You know, give us the ICE vehicles back. Don't give us the 4xEs. We don't want them. They cause too many problems. Jeep fans, man, let me know out there. Are y'all excited? I mean, the people who are excited, in my opinion, are the ones that can afford that $90,000 window sticker. Not even talking about taxes, just the $90,000 window. You're talking about payments in excess of $1,200-$1,300 a month. Come on, man, that's a mortgage out there. There's definitely smarter, smarter financial purchases than a 392 Rubicon, in my honest opinion. But yeah, let's go find some food. I think we're gonna post up somewhere real quick. And then we're gonna go from there. I'm gonna catch up with y'all in a little bit. Peace. Alrighty, y'all. So that's some man, hell with it, man. Lead a blooper in there, man. I just fumbling over these words. That's gonna conclude this video, man. I just pulled up to the Nissan dealership, man. I'm bored, man. We got some time to kill. Y'all see it back there, man. If you know, you know. If not, They got like a Nismo 3, 400Z. I almost said 350Z, but they got a 400Z here. I'm just going to go look at it, walk around. I don't even know if I'm going to finish here and go in and talk to anybody, man. I'm not trying to take it for a test drive. I'm not going to waste nobody's time in there. I might just get a card, get some numbers sent, all that good stuff. It's a good looking vehicle, man. I don't necessarily love the fact that, you know, they only have a Nismo. I think the regular 400Z would be good, but at the end of the day, man, I just kind of wanted to check it out, man. But at the end of the day, thumbs up, comment, subscribe. Let me know what y'all think about the 392, man. What's going on? Are they going to stop with the Wrangler, man? Are they not going to stop with the Wrangler, man? Let's talk about it in the comments, man. Appreciate every last one of you watching. All my new viewers, salute to you. All my returning viewers, salute to you. Peace, love, and prosperity, man. Always strive and prosper. Something I like to, you know, always preach. If there's something you want to go do, man, just go out there and do it, man. Stop doubting yourself. Stop listening to other people that doubt you. Just go do it, man. You'll never, ever, ever know what you can accomplish unless you just start. You don't want to go, you know, 5, 10, shit, even a couple years in the future, man, look back and say, damn, man, I wish I would have, you know, did this, did that. Got mad love for everybody, man. Anytime y'all want to, you know, talk about some stuff, man, in the comments, I respond to everybody. Try me if you don't believe it. I respond to everybody. So even if this video gets 100 comments, best believe I respond every single time or to every single person. Shout out to everybody out there, man. 392 Reviews. Going to check in. We're going to check out. Peace.